they're unboxed.
Oh no, I'm not a huge fan of the styrofoam packing. It kind of explodes everywhere. RS5, this thing looks nice. Here's what's included in the box. On unboxing checkout, big bummer we just found. The front fender is broken. It kind of snapped off. All right, just got her set up. First impressions walkthrough. Got a nice big display up here. That'll be cool. You got single and dual motor. Put your foot up here when off-roading. Check that out, you hold brake. That's super cool. Let me turn on blinkers. That's left side. You got the option for two if you want to charge double as fast, but in the box only comes one. And there we go, light is red, we're charging up. Suspension is one of my key areas of testing an electric scooter. I think it can really make or break the experience of a fun ride. Now this one's got dual suspension, front and rear, a lot of travel and stuff, which is nice. However, when I was preliminary jumping on it, oh wow, that is firm. There's like no bounce. I don't know if that's adjustable or not. However, we've got some rough gravel, terrain, dust, dirt, grass. Let's hit some jumps. Let's just kind of put it to the test with the suspension area and see what it can handle and see how smooth or comfortable a ride it is. And I'm also really curious with these hybrid tires, is it gonna be able to grip the off-road terrain and rip me over and through it all, or is it gonna be spinning out a lot? Let's see. You can kind of see me rattling over this terrain, so that firm suspension, you're gonna kind of feel it a bit more. It's absorbing a little bit, but my hands are definitely shaking a bit.
Now for the speed test, they rate it to go 45 miles per hour max, which is insane. We're down a couple tick marks of battery. My buddy Dalton here is the one with the guts to actually try to hit the top speed, but he's kitted out with safety, so let's do a few test runs. We got the speed gun and see what it hits. All right, so what did it say?
It said I hit 45.
All right, well guess what? You hit 41.
Okay, all right, that's pretty close.
Maybe on a full battery you could squeeze out to the 45. It's 41 still is pretty fast though,
it's
eh?
It's pretty good, yeah.
To show the massive power and torque difference, we're gonna do a little drag race versus the dual trunk. It is literally double, probably even more the price tag, but just to show how much bang for the buck you get on the RoadRunner, let's zip down and do a little race.
3, 2, 1, go!
Right behind us.
One of the great things about this is it's honestly perfect for cities. If you live in a downtown area, you can rip around, keep up with traffic.
That's why you don't buy a GMC right there.
Let's say you live in San Francisco, you need to climb some super steep hills. This thing handles it with ease.
What happened?
I got a little too much airtime right into the turn, and brakes don't work if tires are not touching the ground. Figured that one out.
Little brake test. I'm gonna go really fast around this bend and right at this line, slam on both those hydraulic brakes, lean back, and see how fast we can come to a stop.
Going about 33. Hey!
Dang, that was pretty impressive. I was ripping at about 33 miles per hour, slammed on them. I think that was really impressive brake test. RoadRunner sent me a few goodies, come check it out. A new front fender. So it was really nice they sent out a replacement, sent some new chargers, and a steering dampener. Now we've been riding for a couple of days without it. Let's put it on and see if we can tell a good stability difference. She's installed. Next, let's install the new dampener. This is an optional accessory add-on. Installing the dampener, well, no instructions included, but you unscrew this, put this on, screw that in, and bada bing, got her all done. Took us about 30 minutes. There was no instructions in the pack, but we figured it out. Just make it look like this, and now it looks and feels pretty good.
One thing to note on this throttle control, it's a little bit touchy. It's sort of on or off, and it's a bit harder to kind of finesse that throttle control.
So check us out.
Super easy to pop wheelies. Just kind of got to hold on and stay up right.
First, the suspension was super firm and tight, but after riding and ripping over this thing for a few days, check it out, it's really softened up. Now we're at the end of the day and a little battery range update. We've been cruising for a few hours. Odometer reads 10 miles and we started at 4, so we put about 6 miles on and it went down 2 ticks. Now they rate to go 40 miles range. That's gonna vary based upon rider weight. Are you off-roading, single, dual motor, that sort of thing. I could see maybe that being possible, I'm not sure, but it gives you a rough understanding of the range that we had. Starting with the pros, things I like. The design, it looks cool. I love the color scheme, great ground clearance, overall great build quality, and it feels super sturdy. This rear footrest is perfect for putting that rear foot on for jumps and off-roading. Good stability, it's super strong, not cheap and gonna snap on you. Plus, it's a little bit of a handle to carry around or lift the rear if you need to. I love that locking mechanism. You can tighten it down super secure, feels tight. I like that it can fold down for portability. The steering dampener, overall, I like it. I'm not sure if I would pay more for it. The installation was a bit of a headache, and I have it all the way loosened, and it's still a little bit more firm than I'd prefer. I like these hybrid tires. They were really nice and smooth for on-road, and then enough grippies for off-road terrain. Power, speed, and torque, it's super punchy, can carry you off-roading easily. For that price tag, it seems like great bang for the buck. And for the cons, well, I think the only thing that we could find is that thumb throttle. It just isn't super comfortable or easy to control while you're racing off-road and hold a firm grip. It's not terrible, it's definitely not a deal breaker, but it's probably the only con that we could find. Overall though, I think this thing is a blast. You are getting a lot of power and speed for that price tag. It's great value, and yeah, huge thanks to RoadRunner for sending over the sample unit. No, this video is not sponsored, but let me know any questions you have down in the comments, and I'll see you guys in my next video.